I'm Mike Jarosek, along with
Sean Floss,
bringing you Lion Country Basketball, where tonight the Lions of LT play host to Proviso West. The Lions are 7-3, coming off a 41-32 loss to Homewood last Saturday. LT is in the midst of a three-game losing streak. The Lions look to reverse this trend tonight as they head into the state tournament. Standing at the other end of the court are the Panthers of Proviso West, coming off a 57-54 win over East Aurora. The Panthers are 16-3 on the season, currently ranked 8th in the Chicagoland area, a compliment to Coach Loa Lucas, who is in his final year of coaching at Proviso West. Now for some background on the Lions, here's my partner Sean Floss. Sean, the Lions are on a three-game losing streak. What can you count as the reason for this?
Well, basically it's a young team right now, and they're going to have some sporadic play throughout the season. They're not going to be able to play consistently with the good quality of the team. They're not going to be able to win every single game playing smoothly. They're a young team. They're going to be a little shaky at times, and that just happens to any team. But they've played some great games against some tough teams. They've held in there, even though they've lost a few. They've been in the thick of the game. And right now, they've just got to step up with the momentum and come through here with a big victory against Proviso West.
The starters for Lions Township are as follows. At forward, starting will be John Carroll and Scott Kohler. The starting center is Steve Davis, and starting at guard is Steve Litke and Pat O'Brien. For Proviso West, the starting forwards are Roy Shannon and Brian Wardell. The starting center is Anthony Knox. The starting guards will be Dwayne Vaughn and Deion Lewis.
Proviso West, pretty big team here. They're going to be strong inside and a good perimeter shooting team. They bring everything to the table here. Lowell Lucas, final matchup with Coach Nikovich. Nikovich is just immortal. He's a god of coaching. Two of the finest in the game in the state of Illinois.
The teams are set for action, and the tip is controlled by Proviso West. Vaughn will bring it up. Finds Lewis on the left wing. Lewis takes the three-pointer and hits it.
Right off the bat, there you go. The three, nice setup there with the open man. Hits the open three. Proviso West going to do that tonight. They're going to set it up evenly.
Full court presser by Proviso West. Steve Litke has trouble with it. And Pat O'Brien goes up court, passes deflected, picked up by Steve Davis.
LT not able to spot the open man there. They got to reset the offense here.
Pat O'Brien sets it up for LT, finds Carroll on the left wing. Off the pick from Davis, drives baseline. Shot up, no good. He was called for an offensive foul. Offensive foul on John Carroll. It's his first of the game, the first on the team, as is the first of the game.
Good strong drive there, nice attempt, but you gotta watch out. Proviso West, good defensive team too. Quick on their feet. They're gonna be ready with whatever LT throws at them.
John Carroll is in his fourth game back since being injured.
That's what LT needs. They need the good defense, good strong in-your-face defense. Proviso West very quick off the ball, too.
Vaughn will inbound after O'Brien tipped it out of bounds. It was picked off by O'Brien. The long throw ahead to Carroll. He's got the run out and the score.
Nice, nice play. Good transition offense. Good start for the Lions tonight.
And the Lions are on the board. It's 3-2, 6:48 remain here in the first quarter.
Lions trying to show a little half-court press here. All right, there you go.
Pass was thrown out of bounds. The pass from Vaughn was a little bit too far out than Roy Shannon expected.
Now, Mike, if the Lions can score here, this will be a good play.
Litke drives the lane. Pass was deflected, intended for number 24, John Carroll.
What you need here against a talented squad like Proviso West, turnovers are going to be crucial. You need to cause those turnovers and convert baskets off of them. Lions are going to try to do that tonight.
O'Brien inbounds to Litke, top of the key.
Risky pass.
O'Brien has it left corner off the pick from Davis. Now to Carroll, right wing. Finds Litke, pull-up jumper at the free throw line, no good. Steve Davis then kicks it back out left wing to O'Brien, who gives top of the key to Litke.
If Steve Davis can keep that up, if he could get the offensive boards down low under the glass, set things up for second opportunities, that'll just add to the plus for the Lions tonight. And right now, the free throws are going to start to add up here. You're going to see some physical play down low. You're going to see a bunch of free throws here.
Panther foul was on number 34, Roy Shannon, his first of the game. Scott Kohler is set to shoot two from the free throw line.
Shannon and Knox, big-time players for Proviso West. You like to see them pile up on the fouls, get them out of the game. That'll help.
First shot by Kohler on the way. Good.
And once again, free throws are important. It's an easy basket. Nobody's guarding you. You got to hit those free throws. If they can successfully, the Lions, they'll stay in this game with no problem.
Once again, Proviso West ranked eighth in the Chicagoland area. Kohler's second shot on the way. Hit them both.
Right now, the Lions going to show press here.
Lions has a one-point advantage at 4-3 with 6:16 left here left to play in the first quarter.
They got the trailer setting up the offense.
Brian Wardell threw it ahead to Deion Lewis. Wardell finds himself open in the right corner. Faked the shot, looked inside to Anthony Knox, missed the shot. Back up, blocked by Davis.
Davis, good stuff there. That's the defense you need down low with these big boys.
O'Brien has it left wing. Now to Steve Davis, left corner. Fakes on Knox. Now finds Carroll, free throw line extended. Takes the top of the key. Pass thrown out of bounds. It was intended for Steve Lidke.
Well, you want to get that stuff out of the way early, Mike. That's your turnovers that are a little sporadic. You want to get that out of the way, get the nerves out of the system, and play good basketball here.
Deion Lewis gives to Dwayne Vaughn, and now to Wardell. Vaughn back to Lewis, fakes the three. Now takes the two inside, no good. Rebound fought for. Controlled by Proviso West. There'll be a foul.
Well, you saw the same play set up by Proviso West that they did earlier on their first offensive drive when they hit the three from the left side there. Lions caught up on that. Good defense right up in their face, and he had to force a tough shot. So that's your good defense they need.
Deion Lewis picked up his first foul of the game, the second on Proviso West thus far.
There's your open man.
Kohler had the shot blocked, rebounded by Lidke. Finds Carroll top of the key. Lidke off the pick from Kohler, looked inside and threw it away. Kohler wasn't expecting it.
Well, LT has Steve Davis open down low. This is the third time tonight. They've got to look for him right away if they want an easy layup or draw a foul quickly.
5 minutes exactly to play here in the first quarter. The score is 4-3, Lions Township in the lead. Pass kicked out of bounds by Pat O'Brien. Vaughn looked to Wardell. Deion Lewis will inbound for Proviso West. They free up Wardell, right corner, faces the double team. Now it's Lewis, drives baseline, fakes the shot on Scott Kohler, takes it back outside. Lewis inside to Knox, fakes the shot. Tough shot inside, scored and a foul. Deion Lewis has 5 points so far in the game.
Neon Deion, a primetime shot there. Shows his athleticism, stays up in the air, forces a tough shot, pump fake, and hits it.
Scott Kohler of the Lions picks up his first foul of the game, the second on the team. Lewis sets for the free throw and hits it. 6 points in the game for Deion Lewis. Carroll faces the double team in the full court pressure. Look to Lidke, threw it away. It'll be Proviso West ball off the turnover.
Well, Mike, that was just good defense by Proviso West. You can't blame the Lions there. They're going to bring quickness on their defensive side of the ball and show some good press against the Lions.
4 minutes, 38 seconds remain now. Proviso West is winning 6-4. Wardell fakes the three, looks inside. Tough shot put up, no good. Knox puts it back up, missed that. Shot blocked out of there by Davis, his second of the game.
Once again, Davis showing he's a force down low.
Lidke drives the lane, fakes the shot, and gives to Kohler. Lidke will set back up the offense. Now Carroll on the right wing. Good drive baseline by Kohler. Had the shot blocked by Roy Shannon. The throw ahead went to Deion Lewis. He gives to Dwayne Vaughn. Back to Lewis. Fakes the three. Goes to the side. Takes the two. Rimming good.
And you got to love Coach Lucas. It's his final season, and he's still right down there, fiery as ever.
Deion Lewis has come out shooting. He has 8 points, all 8 points for Proviso West. They have doubled up Lyons Township 8-4 with 3:36 remaining in the first quarter.
Well, if these two coaches aren't inspirational, find me an inspirational coach, because these guys, they're great coaches. They're winners. They want to win the game, and that shows on their players down in the court, and that's what's going to make a good ball game tonight.
Roy Shannon, the starting forward for Proviso West, has picked up his second foul. The third foul on Proviso West so far in the game. There's 3.5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Steve Davis has a right wing for Lyons Township. Looks to pass and finds Steve Litke, who drives baseline. Had the shot blocked by Anthony Knox, and Proviso West came away with it.
Knox is a big boy. You got to watch him when you're down low. He's going to scare him next time he goes up for the jumper.
Anthony Knox, a 6'7", 252-pound senior. Lyons came away with it off the turnover.
And here's what the Lyons need, a quick basket off the turnover that they just caused.
Steve Davis takes the shot over Knox. And
nice shot. You don't want your big men mainly outside shooting the jumpers in a game like this, but in that case, if he could hit them, hey, I don't see anybody complaining.
LT is close to a 2-point deficit. 2:43 remain in the first quarter. It's 8-6 Proviso West lead. Wardell has it right corner. Now to Lewis at the free throw line. Pass was deflected. And now Dwayne Vaughn has it. Faces the double team. Pull-up jumper taken by Roy Shannon was no good.
And a late foul. Looks like it's on Litke. And you got to question the distribution of shots by Proviso West on the floor. The ratio number seems to be high. They're shooting it more so on the left side of the floor. And if the Lions catch up with that and the Proviso West becomes predictable, it's an easy defense setup for the Lions.
2:24 remain in the first quarter. It's 8-6 Proviso West lead. Steve Litke picked up his first foul of the game, the third on the team. Roy Shannon missed his first free throw of the attempt of the game.
Shannon, another big guy here. And even though they're big guy, they're not going to lumber down the court either. If you watch them quick off their feet.
Shannon bricked them both. He remains scoreless.
Knox wants the foul with the motion. He wants his free throws, but he's not going to get it. Kohler hacking Knox up with the shot, but they're not going to give Knox the two free throws.
Telly Lowry checks into the game, a 6'5 junior, weighs 175 pounds for Proviso West. Alley-oop attempt, no good. Wardell came away with it, faces the double team, and now gives to Knox left corner. Lewis fakes the three on O'Brien, tips it away. But to Vaughn inside. Shot good by Roy Shannon. His first 2 points of the game, and it's 10-6 with 2 minutes remaining in the first quarter.
Press once again. There you go. Easy layup right off the steal. You're going to pile up points doing that. Good defense.
Deion Lewis leads all scorers with 10 points of the 12 for Proviso West. Kohler inside had the shot blocked by Knox.
Strong pull.
Put back up by Kohler. Missed it.
Good strong shot by Kohler.
Wardell finds himself free. Missed the layup.
Proviso West
came away with it.
Transitional offense by Proviso West is just extremely good tonight so far.
Litke takes a pass to timeline for LT. Lost control but regains and gives to O'Brien left corner. Takes it left corner. Shoots a three, no good. Came up a little bit short. Wardell came down with the rebound.
Here they go. They're going to come running now.
Gives to Lewis. And now Lowry. Dwayne Vaughn has it. Faces the triple team. Kicks it out to Wardell, who fakes the three. Takes it inside.
Good stab at the ball. Aggressive defense.
Poked out of there. And Pat O'Brien has the runaway. Mm. Anthony Knox came down hustling, but fouled. It'll be his first foul of the game, the fourth of the game on Proviso West. With under a minute to play, Proviso West has Lyons Township doubled up 12-6.
Vicious foul somewhat there by Knox, don't you say?
Pete Sprague will check into the game for John Carroll for Lyons Township.
When Proviso West presses the Lyons, the man you want to see bring the ball up the court is Litke. He's not going to give up the turnover more so than, say, your other guard taking it up, but he's your main man.
Pete Sprague, a 5'9 junior, weighs 140 pounds. Just checked into the game for Lyons Township.
Sprague coming in here trying to provide a spark off the bench here, get the Lions going. They're
O'Brien,
only down five.
O'Brien's second shot on the way, missed it. Proviso West came away with it.
50 seconds to work with here now.
Lewis found himself open, now faces a double team. Kicks it inside to Knox. Shannon was fouled. Foul will be on Scott Kohler. It'll be his second in the game, fourth on the team.
Kohler going airborne there. He meets Shannon on the way up and comes down. Comes down hard, too, but he's okay.
Andy Hedinga checks into the game for Scott Kohler. Hedinga, 6'2 junior, weighs 165 pounds. Lewis fakes the two. Put up the shot, missed it. Now Wardell has it left wing. Faces a double team, gives to Lewis, top of the key.
The Lions are digging their own ditch, giving Proviso West his second chance opportunities. Right now, they're gonna eat up the clock, play for the last shot of the first quarter here.
Now they speed it up with 7 seconds remaining. Five, Knox inside, missed it. 3 seconds, 1 second.
Get it up.
Davis late. Couldn't get it away. And that's the end of the first quarter. Proviso West has the lead, 12-7. We'll be back for second quarter action right after this.
Taking anabolic steroids is like blowing up a balloon. You start slowly, but soon it gets bigger and bigger. And as you feel stronger and stronger, you pump harder and harder. And you think you're shaping up to be a winner until the sensitive organs of your body can't stand it anymore. And you're a loser. Steroids, they're dangerous. Steroids, they produce health problems. Steroids, they kill. The American Chiropractic Association and your family doctor of chiropractic, who are dedicated to a healthy and drug-free America, urge athletes to increase performance naturally. Please say no to all drugs, including steroids.
We're back for second quarter action here at the Lions Township Fieldhouse, where Proviso West is leading 12-7. Deion Lewis leads all scorers with 10 points for Proviso West.
Looking at that first quarter, Mike, Proviso West shows you just how quick and athletic they are, and the Lions are going to have to match that quickly. They're coming in with the transitional offense. It's working well right now for Proviso West, but the Lions, to match that, they got to prevent these turnovers here. They got to come up here with good, stable offense and get the easy J.
Pete Sprague opens at point guard for LT, finds Hedinga at the left corner. Sprague gives to Lidke, right wing. Pass was stolen by Wardell. Take the shot and gave to Lewis.
O'Brien kicking the ball there, right off the old sneaker.
5-point lead for Proviso West, 7 minutes, 34 seconds remain in the second quarter of play. Shannon inbounds Knox. Now Wardell in the corner. Knox inside for the score.
Ho-ho! There's your version of Shaquille right now.
Anthony Knox, first 2 points of the ball game, and Proviso West has Lions Township double up. There's the breakaway. Layup was missed, and LT came away with it.
Well, LT doesn't want to look too bad with these big guys. There's nothing you could do. You can't match them height for height, but you could certainly box out on them.
Sprague has it, top of the key now, gives to O'Brien. Off the pick from Davis, takes it right corner.
Stepped on the line. It's O'Brien. It's a turnover you hate to see here. Proviso West, they're up 7 now, and right now gaining on it.
Lions is taken off the press as the Panthers bring it up. Wardell had to save it to Knox, who faces the double team. Sprague with the steal.
There you go. Go for that loose ball. You don't want to let the lead slip away here now. 7 ain't that bad. You got plenty of time left in the half.
Telly Lowry picks up his first foul of the game. He's the sixth man for Proviso West.
Good movement of the ball.
Davis finds
there
himself
you go.
Open for the slam.
And there it goes, the crowd.
Steve Davis has 4 points, and it's a 14-9 Proviso West lead. 6:23 remain. Proviso West has a 5-point lead, and the crowd is alive.
They're buzzing in the field house.
Lewis gives to Wardell out top. Faces the double team. Kick outside. Open three-pointer on the way.
The silencer, the quiet weapon.
Mark Morrison of Proviso West, the 5'11 junior, hit the three-pointer.
Two great examples of what basketball is all about. You got the big man jamming it down low here, and then you got a little short guy out there popping the three, which is just as effective.
Sprague crosses the timeline for LT. Finds Davis right wing. Fakes on Knox. And gives to Lidke right corner, off the pick from Davis. Lidke finds himself open, drives baseline, was fouled hard by either Anthony Knox or Troy Lewis.
Well, with that jam, Davis is so adrenalized, I bet you could get him to do 20 sprints for you right now. He's got so much energy in him. That did get the crowd going, but of course that three, that'll silence you for a while.
Anthony Knox, the star center for Proviso West, has picked up his second foul of the game with 5:43 remaining in the second quarter. It's 17-9, Proviso West in the lead.
That Lidke, he does hit the deck pretty hard when he gets fouled. Great composure to hit the free throw.
Lidke's first free throw of the game is good. The Lions are 3 of 4 in the game.
Free throws, once again, are crucial. They help, no doubt.
Make it 3 of 5 as Lidke missed the second. Steve Davis came away with it.
Davis doing the work down low against the big man, Knox there. Good job.
Good pass inside to Davis. Sprague found Lidke top of the key.
Lidke's setting up the offense.
Davis fakes on Knox.
Lions showing great patience here, kicking the ball around.
O'Brien faked the three, gave to Lidke out top. O'Brien gets it back off the pick from Davis, now gives it to him. O'Brien, open drive baseline to the hole, missed it.
Rejected.
Roy Shannon came away with the block. Pull-up jumper no good, and the ball is controlled by Brian Wardell. Now Lewis has it. Morrison, open three-pointer on the way, came up short. Rebound, Knox inside, and he was fouled.
Knox got good positioning there, right on top of the ball there with the offensive board. Now he's going for the three-point play.
Steve Davis picks up his first foul of the game. With 4:43 remaining in the second quarter, it's 19-10. Proviso West owns a 9-point lead on the Lions Township Lions. Knox to the line to shoot two. No, to shoot one in the three-point try. Missed it. Shannon back up with it and hit it.
Here's the press again. Once again, a forced turnover. Good defense. It's going to be tough for LT to handle so far. And I just have to laugh at the way these big men, they could jump and jam, but when it comes to a simple free throw, their percentage is very low.
Shannon finds himself open. Nice shot.
Streaking down the baseline. Easy layup.
Hedinga played good defense, but to no avail. Shannon came away with the score. O'Brien drives baseline, faces the double team. Davis was open for a second, faked the shot, now gave to Hedinga. Hedinga has it, takes it right wing, and gives to Peter Sprague. Lidke has it top of the key. Back to Sprague, off the pick from Hedinga, drives baseline. Finger roll layup, missed it. Hedinga back up, and there'll be a foul.
That is the sixth block shot tonight by the Proviso West defense. Lions are doing a great job of penetrating, but just getting caught at the last break there with the block shot. Good defense. And you got to admire the offense by Proviso West. Good balance tonight, too.
Mark Morrison of Proviso West picked up his first foul of the game. So with 4:02 remaining here in the second quarter of action, Proviso West is in control of the game, 23-10. Sean, if you could look to one point why there's a 13-point deficit for LT, what would it be?
Well, I think the Proviso West offense is just too tough to stop right now for them. They're doing a great job of balancing it, and you got to give them credit. They're hitting the three-pointers, the outside shots effectively, and they're pushing it down low with Knox and Shannon. They're doing a great job of forcing it down low. And the Lions, right now, if you look at it, you could tell that pressing defense of Proviso is really, it's manhandling them at points. They're giving up the ball so easily. They've got to be patient. Of course, it's easier said than done, though, because these are some big guys and very quick. But they've got to be patient. They've got to just look for the open man here. Davis has been open down low a few times. You got to look for him. You got to keep your head up in this game. That's what Coach Nikovich is telling them. Keep looking down that court when you've got the ball.
It's important for LT to close the lead to single digits before the half is over. They have 4 minutes to do it, and they're down 13.
And they could easily do it, causing some turnovers against Proviso, just as Proviso has been doing to them, breaking away for some easy layups.
Andy Hedinga is set to shoot two free throws. After the foul is on Mark Morrison of Proviso West.
This is where it all starts right here. Got to hit these two free throws, start some momentum.
Hedinga misses the first. Heading the second free throw on the way. Missed that one in the same place. Lewis takes it inside and gives to Wardell. Pass was tipped away by Pat O'Brien.
Lewis right there to set up the offense now.
Lewis gives to Wardell in the corner, guarded by Hedinga. Now gives top of the key to Mathewson. Lewis drives inside.
Nice.
Scored and a foul.
Sweet.
Lewis now with 12 points, leads all scorers in the game.
Well, he is doing his best imitation of Neon Dion, if only he played basketball too.
It's a 15-point Proviso West lead with 3:39 left in the second quarter. Lewis sets up, attempts a three-point play, missed the free throw. Lidke came away with a rebound.
Proviso West laying off on the defense here. They got a cushiony 15-point lead, 3.5 minutes to go. They're taking it easy.
O'Brien off the pick from Davis. Found Sprague left corner. Now they give us to O'Brien. Hedinga, guarded by Shannon, now gives to Peter Sprague. Steve Lidke off the pick from Davis. Good pick and roll. Davis fakes the shot, back to Lidke. 3 minutes remain. Lidke gives inside to Hedinga, faces the double team, finds an open Pete Sprague, who gives to Steve Davis. Pull-up jumper, bank no good. Proviso West comes away with it. Lewis has the 2-on-1.
Good solid defense at the other end of the floor by Proviso West. Right on them, man for man. Lions could not get off a shot. This is Shannon at the line, shooting two now.
Shannon, a 6'4 senior, weighs 172 pounds, is the starting forward for Proviso West. First free throw on the way for Shannon. No good, I'm sorry, he was in the 1-and-1 situation.
The bonus. Oh. Watch it.
Lidke will take it past the timeline for LT. Guarded by Lewis, will set up the offense with 2.5 minutes remaining. Hedinga gives to Davis. Now O'Brien, right corner, off the pick from Davis. Lidke, pull-up jumper at the free throw line, hit it.
Nice shot. Lidke needs to do that, show some good composure, lead his team back to a comeback.
Lidke has three, and it's a 13-point game with 2 minutes remaining in the second quarter of action.
Good defense by the Lions, causing the turnover. They could slowly creep back into it here. 2:06 to go.
O'Brien will inbound as Lions looks to take advantage of the turnover. Finds Pete Sprague, who then gives to Steve Lidke. Steve Davis got caught up in the air and was fouled. Foul beyond Telly Lowry, the 6'5 junior, weighs 175 pounds.
Lions showed a good example of some good transitional offense there. Pretty smooth. Right now, a minute 57 to go in the half, and what the Lions want to do is show a little bit of a press, probably.
Davis shoots in the bonus, missed it. West came away with it.
Look up.
Davis had the steal and was knocked out of bounds by Shannon. Lions will have possession off the turnover.
Dwayne Vaughn's in there now, show some quick defense. Try to cause a turnover.
O'Brien faces the double team. Missed an open Steve Davis under the basket. Pull up jumper, no foul called. Now, Lewis.
Nice!
Alley oop slam dunk by Shannon. Shannon has six.
Poster
and it's
time.
A 15 point lead. Lions has trouble, a near steal, and Steve Lidke had control. Now it's a 2-on-1.
Late.
Hedinga threw it away.
They're looking for Davis, but a little too late there. Now Proviso West has the momentum on their side.
Ball was knocked out of bounds by Dwayne Vaughn, the 5'10 junior.
Here's 6'9", Brian Collier, 241-pound senior. You know he's in there for one reason, the word block.
1 minute, 18 seconds remain. Davis fakes the shot on Collier, now gives to Sprague, top of the key. Leakey drives baseline. Passes, unfortunately, to Wardell, and Proviso West will have the ball.
Well, Proviso West didn't need the block shot of Collier.
Wardell, guarded by Hedinga, gives top of the key to Lewis. There's the steal by Sprague. He has the run out, one man to beat. He couldn't do it. He was fouled.
Stuffed. Ooh. There is a foul, though. He'll take his free throw gladly.
Lewis went way up and picked up his second foul of the game. 53 seconds remain. It's a Proviso West 15-point lead. 27-12 is the score.
There's been a number of block shots in here, but you don't want to let them take the momentum away just because of that. Lions got to keep patient here. They don't want to be intimidated by this factor of the block shot. Just keep going strong to the basket. If they hit your wrist, it's a foul. The refs will call it. Hopefully they will.
Sprague to the line to shoot two. I would assume that it was in the act of shooting. Shot rims no good. He'll shoot a second.
That's aggravating. You want to hit it so badly because you're running out of time here. Try to do the best for your team late in a situation like this. Closing in on the half.
LT 3-of-6 on free throw shooting in the half. Sprague set for his second of the game. Put it up, no good, he missed them both. And it remains a 15-point lead with 51 seconds. Proviso West will have the ball as Lions came away with nothing on that trip.
Lions look like they're settling back for the man-to-man defense here.
Vaughn gives to Wardell. Good pass inside to Lowry, who scores.
Good execution, get the ball down to your big man, go straight up with it.
Telly Lowry has 4 points for Proviso West, and it's a 17-point lead with 30 seconds remaining in the half. Kick inside to Hedinga, shot it in.
There you go, the Lions coming right back with some good transitional offense.
Good feed from Steve Lidke to create the basket.
Looks like Proviso are going to play for the last shot of the half here.
Lowry gives to Vaughn up top, guarded by Lidke.
Vaughn's doing a fine job of setting up the offense tonight.
Takes it right wing. Shot was blocked by Steve Davis, his
Get
third
it up.
Of the game.
No. Close.
Shot rimmed out if it would have counted. Pat O'Brien missed it at the end of the first half. That is the end of the first half with a score, 29-14. Proviso West has a 15-point lead. We'll be back for second half action right after this.
What do you really give when you give blood?
Another summer. Another dance.
Hi.
Another song. Another hug.
Good game, man. Don't worry about it.
Another date. Another moment.
I love you.
When you give blood, you give another chance.
Pete Sampras comes up to serve. Jan Stevenson makes the drive. A.C. Green and Charles Smith pound the boards. Marcus Allen rushes up the middle. Jay Schrader with the touchdown. There are a lot of different parts to play in the American Red Cross. Play your part.
Starting for the Lions, first team, number 10, Peter
We're back for second half action at the Lions Township Fieldhouse, where Proviso West leads the Lions Township 29-14. Unofficial stats for the first half are as follows. Steve Davis has 4 points for Lions Township. Steve Lidke has 3. Dennis Carroll and Scott Kohler each have 2. And Pat O'Brien has 1. For Proviso West, Deion Lewis leads all scorers with 12. Terrell Lowry has 6. Roy Shannon also has 6. Anthony Knox has 4. And Mike Morrison has 3. We're set for second half action. Sean, if you could point to any reason why there's a 15-point deficit for Lions Township, what would it be?
Well, I'll tell you two big reasons. Anthony Knox and also Roy Shannon, two big players down low. They've been a force. They haven't necessarily been big scores or put up big numbers from the field goal percentage range, but just their presence down low. They're big men. They're going to force intimidation upon you. They're going to bring that defensive tenacity against you, and that's been a big reason. The Lions have not been able to shoot effectively down low. Also, the man-to-man defense by Proviso West has been just awesome tonight. The Lions, if they want to come back and win this game, I said they got to come back with that same style of defense, just match them up man for man, cause a turnover here or there, get some easy baskets, but also set up a good open shot.
Shannon, long inbound pass to Lewis. Pass inside to Knox, found himself open and hit the layup.
There it is, Knox again. They start right off successfully down low with the big man, and that's going to continue if the Lions can't stop it.
Anthony Knox with 6 points. And it's a 31-14 lead for Proviso West. Davis has it right wing for Reliance Township. Fakes the shot, gives to Sprague, who had the open three, didn't take it. Now takes the two at the free throw line, missed that. Kohler fights for the rebound, but Knox came away with it.
You gotta like Coach Lucas's style tonight. He's going with what works. That's what keeps his team winning. Knox has been able to shoot down low, and he's been doing that.
Knox has it at the free throw line. Now Lewis. Good rebound by Knox. He put it back up and in.
The offensive board off the glass. Easy basket.
Knox has come out with 4 points to start the second half, and it's 33-14. Proviso West has the advantage. Davis fakes the shot on Knox. Now gives it to Lidke in the right corner. Lost control. Pass tipped out of bounds to Lions Township.
The Lions are getting tentative now because of that defense. It's coming right up on them man for man. They don't know who to go to and where to take their shots. They got to make decisions fast.
O'Brien will inbound after Vaughn knocked it out of bounds. O'Brien finds Lidke right wing. Guarded by Lewis. Now has the top of the key. O'Brien drives inside. Pass tipped away and controlled by Proviso West.
When you're winning, it just seems like the loose ball goes your way. It's like a magnet to you. It's coming right in your hands. That's how it's been going for Proviso tonight.
We're 30 seconds into the second half. It's 33-14. Proviso West in the lead. Wardell takes the pull-up jumper over O'Brien and hit it.
He was open, sets up for the nice J, strokes it downtown.
Brian Wardell has his first basket of the game. And Ron Nikovich wants a timeout. Earlier today, the sophomore team for Lions Township defeated Proviso West 56-32. Mike Workentine led Lions Township in scoring with 13 points. Freshman Graham Alexa had 12. Derek Robinson had 11. Dennis Carroll and Brian Marks each added 8. Once again, our score here in the third quarter with 6 minutes 24 seconds remaining is 35-14. Proviso West is in control.
Right now, Coach Nikovich takes a timeout. He wants to regroup the troop here, down by a large sum, as you can see, 6:24 to go. And we need a Lion that size on our court right now to help us. That's the size of Knox right now, the way he's been looking down low.
That was a Lion?
Yes.
There's a Lion. And we're ready to resume action. 6 minutes, 24 seconds remain in the third quarter. Pete Sprague has it with full court pressure. Drives past Shannon, gave to Lidke, passed over the timeline to O'Brien. Shot on Knox, no good, rebound. Shannon had it.
Jump ball here.
Good hustle by Scott Kohler. It'll be a jump ball, and Lions had the arrow.
Looked like he had an easy layup. Turning around there, Knox was right in his face.
O'Brien inbounds for LT, gave to Lidke. O'Brien, three-pointer on the way. Good defense by Wardell, deflected the three-point attempt. Lewis fakes the three on Lidke. Now gives to Wardell. Vaughn Gives to Shannon. Back out to Vaughn, top of the key, guarded by Sprague. Gives left wing to Wardell. Off the pick from Knox. Lewis inside to Vaughn. Back to Knox, faces the double team. Pass was thrown away to Lidke.
Good give and go.
Good feed to Pat O'Brien, who has the run out and scores.
Good execution by the Lions.
O'Brien now has 3 points. And it's a 35-16 lead for Proviso West with 5 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Vaughn brings it up, guarded by Sprague. Finds Knox inside, good give and go. Vaughn faces the double team. Good pass into Shannon inside.
That's Lewis. Nice play. Pump fake shot. Draws the foul.
Vaughn Lions Township will most likely be on Steve Lidke. Lidke's second of the game.
Up 19 points. Coach Lucas does not quit reprimanding his players. He's talking to Dwayne Vaughn. He's telling him on defense, you got to clear out of the way there.
Deion Lewis now has 13 points. He is 2 of 3 from the free throw line so far. Second shot by Lewis is in.
Well-disciplined offense and defense by Proviso tonight. Coach Lucas has had his troops ready to play.
Lidke breaks the press and takes a pass to timeline for Lions Township. Good feed to Steve Davis. Kick outside to an open Pete Sprague, missed the shot, and Shannon came away with it. Proviso West has the run out. Lewis fakes the shot, gave it to Knox, comes away with it inside and scored.
Little garbagey offense there, trying to be a little too fancy with the ball, but Knox with his size was able to take advantage with the layup.
Anthony Knox has 10 points, and it's a 39-16 lead for Proviso West. Anthony Knox blocked Steve Lidke's shot out of bounds. John Carroll comes in for Pete Sprague. Sprague had it long extended at time on the court. And Lions Township will have the ball out of bounds. O'Brien inbounds to Kohler. Now Lidke right wing. Guarded by Vaughn, takes it right corner. Faces the double team. Gives it to O'Brien right wing. Guarded by Wardell. Good pass to Davis, who drives on Knox. Shot is in.
Nice drive, Davis, making things happen. Good penetration.
6 points for Steve Davis, and with 4 minutes, 12 seconds remaining here in the third quarter, it's 39-18. Proviso West has doubled up Lions Township. Wardell, nice shot inside.
Well, Proviso comes right back with their penetration. Wardell coming in with a nice J.
Wardell, the starting forward for Proviso West, has 4 points. O'Brien fakes the shot, threw it away to Wardell. Throw ahead to Vaughn, left corner, fakes the shot on Lidke, drives inside and hits the shot. Dwayne Vaughn has his first 2 points of the game, and there's 3 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the third quarter. O'Brien faces the double team and was fouled. Foul will be on Mark Morrison, his second of the game.
Proviso not letting up on the defense there. They're still getting right in LT's face.
Carroll gives to Lidke, who tries to break the full court pressure. Finds O'Brien right wing. Now Davis, pull-up jumper, right baseline, missed it. Shannon came away with the rebound, gave to Vaughn. Vaughn faked the pull-up jumper, instead gave to Shannon right baseline. Vaughn sets up the offense, guarded by Lidke. Sets up the isolation for Wardell. Finds Knox inside. Back no good. Vaughn came away with it. Found himself open. No one was guarding him, but he didn't see it. Vaughn takes it right wing. Gives to Morrison. Off the pick from Lowry. Missed the shot. Rebound fought for and controlled by Steve Davis.
It's getting rough down there. Davis had to claw for that one.
Blocking foul on Proviso West. Most likely on Mark Morrison, it would be his third. It's on Dwayne Vaughn, his first foul of the game. 2.5 minutes remain in the third quarter. It's 43-18. Proviso West is in control of the game so far.
Andy Hedinga checking in for Scott Kohler.
Lidke has the top of the key, guarded by Vaughn. Turns, takes the pull-up jumper at the free throw line and hit it.
Sweet turnaround J by Lidke. He backs up right in there through the lane, takes his shot.
Lidke with 5 points, and it's a 23-point lead with 2 minutes remaining in the third. Morrison gives to Vaughn.
Wardell, nice work of the ball. Gets right around Davis. Good layup.
Wardell now has six, and it's a 25-point game.
Back on defense, the jam.
And the slam by number 32, Telly Lowry, who has 8 points.
He wants to get on the dunk fest here tonight. They're having fun.
Carroll looks to break the press. O'Brien fake the shot on Knox. And the foul will be called on Knox. His third of the game.
Proviso not letting up one bit. Coach Lucas making sure they're still in this one. Their heads are on straight and they're playing here to win. Right now, you replace the big man with the big man. Brian Collier coming right in for Knox.
Collier played a minute 18 in the first half. Hedinga kicks it outside for three by Lidke, missed it. Rebound Steve Davis, takes the shot, he was double teamed, missed it. We'll have a foul on Collier, who just checked in.
Collier comes in there, he's not gonna bring great offense on the court, but he's there for that presence of his defense. They're gonna keep him in there to plug the hole down low, keep the Lions from taking any easy opportunity baskets.
Steve Davis, the 6'7 junior, weighs 190 pounds and hit the first free throw.
Davis showing a nice soft touch tonight with the ball, shooting pretty good.
Lions shooting 42% so far from the free throw line as Steve Davis hits the second free throw. Davis now with 8 points. Proviso West looks to inbound, finds Wardell.
Full court pressure.
Lewis throw ahead. Collier fought for it. Steve Davis came away with it. He gives to O'Brien, and Lions will bring it up, trying to take advantage of the turnover with 1 minute remaining in the third quarter. It's 47-22. Proviso West holds a 25-point lead on Lions Township. Carroll baseline jumper, hit it.
Nice shot, gets it high up. Arch in the air, swish.
John Carroll now with 4 points, and it's a 23-point game. Under a minute to play in the third. Foul will be on John Carroll, his second. Carroll, after starting, sat for almost the entire second quarter. Now he's back in the third.
Roy Shannon gonna check in for Brian Wardell right now for Proviso.
Shannon having a fine game from the field. He has 6 points, but from the free throw line, it's a different story. He's 0 of 3. Wardell gives to Lewis on the right wing, guarded by Lidke. Found Collier inside. Kick back out to Lewis, free throw line. Missed it, put it back up, no good. And it went out of bounds to Proviso West. Lidke knocked it out of bounds.
Lions looking a little tired down low here, trying to fight for those rebounds. They look like they're letting up just a bit.
38 seconds left in the third quarter. It's a 23-point Proviso West lead. Collier inside, shoots on Davis and missed it, long. Rebound O'Brien, gives to Lidke, he'll cross the timeline for LT. O'Brien, open three-pointer on the way, no good. Missed it right and went up and over the backboard, it'll be Proviso West ball.
This does tire you out when you have to cover a guy like Knox down low or Shannon for Proviso. Those big bodies banging up against you going down low for positioning. It's a wear and tear on you and it'll wear you out later in the game.
Wardell faces the double team on the pressure of LT. Now they have the 3-on-1 advantage. Collier inside for the slam.
Dunk City.
Collier's first 2 points of the game, and with 8 seconds remaining, 7, now 5. O'Brien takes the shot with 2 seconds, no good. 1, and that'll do it for the third quarter of action. It's a 25-point Proviso West lead, 49-24. We'll be back for fourth quarter action right after these messages.
with your host, Crash Dummies, Vince and Larry.
Hi.
Hello. And welcome to the show that proves if you don't buckle your safety belt, the loser is you.
That's right, Vince. And by not buckling up, you could end up in places you never dreamed.
Like traction.
Or the emergency room.
Plus, Larry, if you're not buckled up, you could maybe take a ride in a beauty like this. Stay tuned.
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Buckle your safety belt.
Airbags are great when you're hit from the front. But if somebody says you don't have to buckle up anymore...
Tell them they're full of hot air.
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Buckle your safety belt.
We're back at the Lions Township Fieldhouse for fourth quarter action, where Proviso West leads 49-24. Earlier today, the sophomore team of Lions Township defeated Proviso West 56-32. Mike Workentine led the LT scorers with 13 points. Graham Alexa added 12, and Derek Robinson had 11. Now Proviso West has the ball in this game right here. Vaughn turnaround jumper missed it. Kohler came away with the rebound. Litke has it left wing. Drive inside, knocked out of bounds. Lions will retain possession. O'Brien inbounds to Lidke. Carroll long outside three-pointer, no good.
Lions got to go to those threes and three now, trying to play catch-up.
Lewis has it guarded by Carroll. Wardell, open three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound, Anthony Knox. Fell down, kept his dribble, found Shannon, missed the shot. Shannon got his own rebound, but Pat O'Brien tore it away and found Lidke.
Once again, for the umpteenth time tonight, Davis was open down low.
John Carroll drove baseline and was fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two with 7 minutes, 12 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter of play. 49-24 is the score. Proviso West is in the lead.
And Mike, I don't like what I'm seeing from Proviso. They're up here by 25 points and they're shooting threes. I don't know if they're trying to rub it in or if they're just trying to look good themselves popping threes, but that doesn't show good sportsmanship.
Roy Shannon picked up his third foul of the game for Proviso West. John Carroll hits the first free throw for LT. His first free throw of the game. Lions is 6 of 13 in the game. Second free throw rims out.
Davis doing a good job tonight of those boards down low.
O'Brien, open three-pointer. No good. He came up long. Lewis came away with it. Wardell finds Knox inside, shoots on Davis, bank and good. Anthony Knox now has 12 points for Proviso West. There's the steal.
And he's going for the three-point play.
Deion Lewis scores once more. He now has 14 points in the game. He'll go to the line to attempt his 15th.
He's had a good game tonight, Deion. Doing a great job setting up the offense, penetrating, dishing it off to the open man.
Proviso West now 4 of 12 from the line. That's only 33%.
They are predominantly big men. They're not going to hit their free throws too much.
Deion Lewis leads all scores with 15. Carroll drives inside. Gave to Scott Kohler. Missed it. Got his own rebound. Shoots on Knox. No good. Kohler tries it again. This time he missed it again.
Good effort by the boys, though. You got to like it. Not letting up a bit.
Call that you don't see often at the high school level is basket interference, but here it is. The score will be credited to Scott Kohler. Kohler now with 4 points in the game.
That's a gimme. He'll take that any day.
...54-27 is the score with 6 minutes, 18 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter of action.
Proviso looking to eat up the clock. The clock is their friend now.
Knox inside, shoots it on Davis, missed it. Kohler came away with the rebound. Davis open on the runout, reverse layup. He hit.
Nice. Can you imagine if the Lions found Davis open for every time he was open tonight? I know that's impossible, but at least half the time he was open, that's what we would have seen tonight, a closer game from those layups.
Davis now with 10 points. Here's Wardell, guarded by Lidke. Wardell cuts to the basket, found himself open. Rebound Knox, scored and a foul.
Knox has just been awesome. I don't like to rub it into the Lions fans, but you got to admit, the kid does have some talent. He is strong down low. But I like what Steve Davis has done tonight, Mike. He's gotten the offensive boards when the Lions needed him, second chance opportunities. He's played good defense. He's done a good job.
Knox with 14 points, including 10 in the second half alone. Brick the free throw. Kohler came away with the rebound. Long throw ahead to Pat O'Brien. Layup, no good.
Well, they're finding the open men now, but unfortunately it's too late.
Wardell, open three-pointer, he hit it.
Well, Proviso doesn't seem to see a reason why they shouldn't stop taking those threes, and Wardell continues to take them.
Morrison now with 6 points in the game, and it's a 30-point Proviso West lead. Davis found Carroll on the right wing. Good move by John Carroll. Pull-up jumper, he missed it. Shannon had the rebound. Now Lewis has the top of the key, guarded by Spray. Drives past him. Now they give it to Knox, who scores once more. He's got 16 points now.
Strong down the baseline there.
61-29 is the score with 4 minutes, 37 seconds remaining in the game. Carroll drove baseline, no good. Kohler put it back up and in, and he was fouled on the play.
I could count two fouls throughout that drive there, but we'll take that one.
Scott Kohler now with 6 points in the game. Anthony Knox picks up his fourth foul of the game. Mass substitutions by Proviso West with 4 minutes, 28 seconds remaining, and it looks to be out of reach for Lyons Township. It's a 30-point deficit.
Coach Lucas bringing in his boys from deep off the bench, guys that don't get much playing time. They're going to come in here, get some experience for down the stretch in the season.
Free throw was missed by Kohler. He tried to complete the three-point play. Pull-up jumper, no good. Rebound pulled out of there by Steve Davis. LT lost control. No one saw it coming. Now it's Terry Brunson making his first appearance of the game. Gave to Nick Eggert. Brunson back to Eggert inside. Shot blocked by O'Brien. Brunson kicks it outside to Mark Morrison. Missed the three-pointer. Lions had two attempts, missed them both, but they'll have possession. It's still a 30-point deficit, 3 minutes, 44 seconds remain in the game.
Just when you think things are going bad, they're going bad even more so. Lions can't even buy a basket.
If the trend continues, the Lions will fall to 7-14 on the season. Kohler inside was fouled. Fouls on number 34, Roy Shannon, a 6'4", senior, weighs 172 pounds.
Lonzel Ratcliffe coming into the game. Gotta like that name.
Coach Lowell Lucas clearing out the bench here. 3.5 minutes remain. It's a 30-point advantage for Proviso West. Kohler, free throw on the way, no good. He'll have one more.
This is Wayne Vaughn. We were worried about that, getting those names mixed up a little earlier, Luane and Dwayne, but no problem. Luane coming in late here.
Kohler, second free throw on the way, he hit it. 29-point lead for Proviso West. 3 minutes, 39 seconds remain in the fourth quarter of play. Three-pointer, no good. Rebound, Collier. Was fouled by Steve Davis. Davis, the second foul of the game. The past 3 years that Lyons Township has played for Proviso West, each game has gone into overtime. It looks like the trend will stop at this game.
Well, it's always been a classic matchup between Coach Lucas and Nikovich, but this is a game now where Proviso needs this one bad. They need it down the stretch to improve the ranking, and they just came out here with so much fire and emotion and tenacity. They just came out here to win. They were out for blood on defense, and they showed it, and the Lions just, they couldn't handle it.
Lidke takes past the timeline for Lions Township. O'Brien pull up three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound Proviso West. DeJuan Kelly came away with the rebound for Proviso. Now Terry Brunson gives to LaWayne Vaughn. Off the pick from Radcliffe. Vaughn has it guarded by Carroll. Brunson. Looks inside to Kelly. Put up the shot, no good. Carroll had the rebound. O'Brien has the ball, spins and dribbles away from the defense. He threw it out of bounds. Proviso West will have the ball. 2 minutes, 45 seconds remain. 63-32 is the score. Andy Bush checks into the game for Lions Township, replacing Scott Kohler.
Mike Steemack also checking in for the Lions.
Steemack, a 5'11 junior. Weighs 150 pounds.
2:40 to go in the game.
31-point lead for Proviso West. Collier, turnaround jumper on Davis, no good. Rebound, Steve Lidke. John Carroll drives baseline, missed the shot. Bush fought for the rebound, Carroll won. Carroll drives the baseline and scores.
Nice movement to the hoop down the baseline.
Carroll now with 6 points. Just over 2 minutes remain in the game. Vaughn sets up the offense, guarded by Carroll. Now Brunson finds Collier inside. Missed the shot. Rebound won by Radcliffe.
If only Collier was taking 80% of the shots tonight, we'd have a lead here.
Vaughn gives to Egger. Now inside to Collier, shoots one more time and hit this one.
Nice to know you could make it after four attempts.
I think you heard you, Sean. Now Lidke drives inside, finds Bush on the baseline. Andy Bush will go to the line to shoot two free throws. Bush, one of the many juniors of Lions Township. It weighs 205 pounds and stands 6'3".
Proviso bringing in DeJuan Kelly, number 22. Number 50, Jomo Bettis. And also number 41, Eric Goodman.
Nick Eggert and Brian Collier sit down for Proviso West. Bush, first free throw on the way, rimming no good. Lions Township will have two home games remaining after this game versus Proviso West, so be sure to come to the Lions Township Fieldhouse to see the teams play as they prepare for the Illinois State Tournament.
You left something behind there.
Irby looks inside to Bettis. Turns and shoots, no good. Bush the rebound.
Well, what is this? Proviso looks short here. No 6'9 player for us to watch. Steemack driving the lane. Nice soft layup.
Steemack with his first 2 points of the game. And with 1 minute remaining, it's 37-65. Proviso West in the lead. Rebound put back, no good. We'll have a jump ball.
It'll be LT ball.
Bob Clapperidge and Todd Egger checking the game for Lions Township.
Well, Coach Nikovich bringing in his players from deep off the bench to get some playing time.
Mark Wojtowicz also checks in for LT.
50 seconds exactly remain in the fourth quarter of play. It's 65-37, Proviso West in control.
In this type of game, the score doesn't really tell the story because it was a pretty exciting game so far.
Clapperidge fouled. Foul was on Maffeo Irby, a 5'10 junior, weighs 165 pounds. Irby's first foul of the game. Sean, if you could name a player of the game for Lyons Township, who would you say?
Well, Steve Davis, I think. He's done a great job defensively. Pretty good, subpar offensively, but I think very good for, you know, his type of position. You don't really look for that guy to take your shots, but unfortunately, he's been the only one who's been able to take them, and he's hitting them.
Rebound Wojtowicz. By the way, I would agree with that choice of Steve Davis as player of the game. He has 10 points and has been... He's had a tough assignment versus Anthony Knox, and I think he's responded pretty well.
Oh, yeah, it's surprising that he has done that good, not because of him, but because of Knox down low.
Clapperidge,
he's handled him well.
Clapperidge's three-pointer missed it. Kelly has the breakaway and score.
DeJuan Kelly. Now you got 19 seconds left to go.
Steemack gives to Clapperidge up top. Free throw line jumper by Clapperidge, no good. Rebound fought for and controlled by Proviso West. Another run out opportunity for Proviso and a slam by Joe Mo Bettis.
One last dunk to finish off a good game.
That'll do it from the Lyons Township Fieldhouse. A 32-point victory for Proviso West pushes the Lyons Township Lions to 7-14 on the season. We'd like to thank you for joining us here on Lion Country Basketball, where tonight, once again, our final score is Proviso West 69, Lyons Township 37. That's all from Lyons Township High School. I'm Mike Jarosik along with
Sean Floss.
Wishing you a happy weekend.
Good night.